My name is John Thornton, and for many years I have been a highly respected and much beloved teacher at an art school on the East Coast. My school has a dedicated band of mental health semi-professionals to deal with the angst which so typically bedevils art school communities. But just as it takes a village to raise a child, it takes more than just our wonderful counseling department to grapple with the fears and dysfunction of an entire art school. Being the caring nurturer that I am, I decided to pitch in by making a therapeutic video. By empowering people to speak about their fears, I believe that they may be able to cope a little better. Many of these fears are quite honestly utterly absurd. And I open my film with perhaps the most irrational fear of all, the fear of me. So, what are you afraid of?
I'm afraid of Mr. Thornton.
I am afraid of John Thornton. When he sticks a microphone in my face, it makes me nervous. Should I eat it or talk into it?
Many of the splendid bunch of coconuts that make up our art school community were afraid of the animal kingdom.
There's a few things, but for some reason I'm drawing a blank. But I don't like rodents.
The only thing I'm afraid of is mouses.
I'm afraid of rats. Rodents, anything that can move faster than me and is that small, is very frightening.
I'm afraid of wrestling bears because I did that once.
I'm afraid of snakes because I got one stuck in my hair once on the bus.
Snakes and bugs.
I'm afraid of roaches and ended up being a cat lady.
Sharks.
I'm afraid of the dark. And spiders?
I'm afraid of spiders.
When I was 4, I was sitting in the backseat of the car, and I felt something touch my hand, so I looked down, and it was a spider, and I scream, and my parents thought I was dying, so we pull over the car really fast, and they open the door, and they think I'm dying, and they're like, what's wrong, and I'm like stepping on the spider, but it's not dying, because the cushions is like going in, and I'm freaking out, and it was on my blanket, and my parents are like, okay, come out of the car, and they were like messing around. And they never found the spider, but they told me that they killed it and it went outside the car. But later on, like, they said, oh yeah, we never found the spider. It was probably still right next to you. So now I'm afraid of spiders.
In addition to arachnophobia, our art school community is often troubled about the future.
Spiders?
Anything better than that?
The collapse of our civilization.
I'm afraid of the future.
My biggest fear of the future is that everybody will become totally selfish and only worry about themselves and not be willing to do anything to help the common good.
Apathy.
George Bush.
Of course I'm concerned about the economy.
I'm afraid of not being able to continue paying for the school, so I'll have to go back home, because that would suck. And spiders. I'm afraid of spiders.
I'm afraid that our president, Barack Obama, is going to, like, ruin everything. No, I hope that he doesn't ruin everything, and I hope that nobody assassinates him, because he's really cute.
I'm afraid that Hillary Clinton may actually become Secretary of State. That scares me.
Yeah, I'm afraid of failing because I want to be really successful in life, and I'm afraid I won't be.
Afraid of losing control of my future.
I guess I'm just afraid of being penniless.
Proposition 8.
And still there's unease about the evildoers amongst us.
Angry people with knives.
I'm really afraid of guns because they're really scary and everybody dies from guns.
I'm afraid of dudes with guns in my face.
That's scary.
I'm afraid of being raped.
Bombs.
I'm afraid of Mexicans, puto.
I'm afraid of killing someone because I have a really short temper and a really low intolerance.
The breakdown and decay of our bodies and eventual death is never a laughing matter.
I'm afraid of death. I'm afraid that when I wake up from the surgery, I won't be able to do what I used to do. I'm also afraid that I won't wake up.
My seizure's destroying me.
Yeah. Getting old.
I'm so afraid that it's gonna fly out and poke me in the eye.
Flesh-eating bacteria.
Death.
And we will end with a lightning round of, shall we say, unusual fear.
I'm afraid that my Microsoft Outlook is going to poop out on me again.
I'm afraid in my yoga class that there's going to be an asana that I'm going to get stuck into and not be able to get out of.
I'm afraid of heights.
I'm afraid of women's thoughts because they are very erratic, and that's it.
Public speaking.
I'm claustrophobic.
Ricky Tiki Tembo, No Saw Rembo, Paraparamuchi, Pit Pray Pembo has fallen into the well.
Okay, I'm afraid of holes in the ground, like deep holes in the ground, like I won't walk over subway grates. And I am afraid of dark alleys, I just will not walk down them, like, at all. But that's pretty much it.
I'm afraid of the dark and clowns.
I'm afraid of elevators in the 1510 building.
In closing, I have to point out that this kind of groundbreaking psychovideotherapy is very expensive to produce. And notwithstanding the generous subsistence-level wages I receive for my pedagogic work, the school is yet to formally invite me to become part of the paid counseling department. Therefore, any contributions of a financial sort would be gratefully accepted. Thanks.
Did freak out over a spider. It was huge.